In this movie, I'll be demonstrating how you can easily position and rotate a mirror axis before applying. In this simple example artwork, which I'm going to select, I then go to the MirrorMe tool, and what I want to do is mirror the artwork around an axis which starts at this point here to the opposing point here. What I will do now is click first on this point and then drag and release over this point here, noting that I have the smart guide system enabled. I'll release the cursor here, and you can reposition this dialog box if you find it's in the way. And what I can do before applying to the selection is to continue to edit this mirror axis. I can edit the origin of the axis by clicking and dragging here. And whilst I've got the mouse held down, I can use the numbers on the keyboard, 1 to 9, to specify the number of axes, or I can use these square bracket keys, like so. And I can reposition at any point, like so. And I can then click and drag on any of the axes markers to position it at any angle I desire. So I can release the mouse like that. I can also rotate and pan or move around the origin simultaneously. To do so, whilst holding down the mouse key, I'm going to hold down the space bar as well. And you can see that I'm both moving the actual origin as well as controlling the axis of mirroring where I've got it selected, like so. So if I let go of the space bar, I can continue to rotate it. So I can apply to the selection here and look at the end result. Let's undo that and let's go back to the mirroring operation, and this time I'm going to mirror along a certain vertices in this artwork. Let's zoom into one. And we have here an angle that is quite obscure and unknown, but I want to mirror around the axis. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to go back to the mirror tool, and with the default preferences, I'm going to click anywhere along that vertices, and I'm going to, whilst holding the mouse button down, press the number 1 for a single axis. And then I'm going to simply drag to anywhere else along that vertices. And you can see it's automatically snapping to that point when I go within a threshold value of it. I'm going to let go and apply to selection again. And it has applied to that particular vertices on that artwork. I'll undo that and redo that. You can see that vertices here has been the axis of mirroring. Let's continue to look at how you can apply that to a curved segment. And for that I'm going to change over to this example artwork. And I'm going to select all the artwork and zoom in. And I want to mirror around a perpendicular point along this curve here. And for that I'm going to click once. And then I'm going to drag this axis. And I'm going to drag the point back over the origin marker, and you can see it automatically snaps to a perpendicular at that point of origin with that curve. I can now apply to selection. If I zoom out, you can see that the axis of mirroring is perfectly tangential to that smooth curve there. The final thing I'm going to show is reverting to the original artwork, is how to ensure that the mirroring axis is at a certain angle, that is midpoint to the active sector. For this I'm going to return to the mirror tool, and I'm going to click here and drag, and I'm going to release at any arbitrary angle, but before I do so I'm going to make sure I have 6 axes here. And what I want is this active sector here to be centralized to this point. And as you can see, if I go in the middle of this active sector, you see a dotted annotation appear, and I can click and drag that and snap that to that point there. And by applying to selection, what has happened is that the axis of mirroring has perfectly coincided with this point here and the original point down here. All these techniques may be applied to both the application to a selection or a layer.